In this tutorial, we are going to animate this two-part loading text using geometry nodes. This is a follow-up to my previous tutorial, where we made an actual loading bar animation. I recommend you go watch it as well. Let's go! Open Blender with the default scene. Press X to delete the default cube. Press Shift A and add a mesh plane. Down here, change the frame count to 100 frames. Next, we can go to the geometry node workspace up here. Add a new geometry node tree. Delete this group input node with the X shortcut. Press Shift A and add a text string to curves node and plug it to the geometry slot. Then add a text slice string node and plug it to the string slot. Type loading with three dots here. We can change the view up here to see what we are doing. Then we can add a fill curve node and drop it here. If we want some extrusion to the text, we can add an instance realized instance node here. This allows us to use a solidify modifier so we can control the extrusion more easily. You don't have to use this if you don't want to. Select geometry nodes modifier to continue. Then we can add a material set material node here. Go to the materials tab so we can add some colors. Let's add a white material. Also a black material. You can change the color down here. And finally, let's add a green material. Or feel free to use whatever colors you like. So, let's select the white material for our loading text. We can animate the text using the input value node. This works in two ways. You can plug it here, and you can animate this in both ways. Or you can plug it down here, so you can animate without worrying about the minus value. Let's change the value so we can see the whole text. Next, we can create the green OK text. Press B key and select all these nodes. Then press Shift D to duplicate them all. Then, let's change the loading text to OK. We can also change the material to green. We need to add a geometry, join geometry node, so we can see them both. But now they are overlapping each other. We can fix this by adding a geometry transform node here. We can move the OK text here in the X value. At this point, I'm going to change the font, because we are going to need to adjust the OK text more after that. We can also add some variation by scaling the text like this. Let's animate all this next. Change this OK text value so it is visible. Up here, we can change this window to dope sheet so we can see our keyframes. Let's move the playhead to around 40 frames in the timeline. Press I shortcut to create a keyframe for the loading text value. Then go to frame 1 and type 0 for the value node and add another keyframe. Then go few frames forward. Drag this value node backwards so the dots disappear. Press I to add another keyframe. Select this keyframe, press T and change the interpolation to constant. Now the dots disappear instantly. Then select these two keyframes. Press Shift D to duplicate them. Place them a few frames forward. Then we can press Shift R to repeat the last action. Now when we play this, it looks a little bit like the intro. Except we need to select the first keyframe. Press T and change the interpolation to linear. Now the speed is the same. Leave the playhead around here. Next we animate the OK text. Press I to add a keyframe to the OK value node. We can collapse this list to see more. Go few frames backwards. Set value to 0 and add another keyframe. Awesome! Next we can add a stroke to our text. If you know a better workflow, please comment down below. Here's my version. First, let's add a curve to mesh node, and plug this here. Then we can duplicate this set material node with Shift D shortcut, and plug this here. Then we can connect this to the join geometry node. Let's add a curve primitives quadrilateral and hook it to the profile slot. Stroke is quite big now, so let's scale it down. Let's change the material to black. Next, let's do the same to the OK text. So select these two nodes, press Shift D to duplicate them over here. Plug this here, and this one to the profile curve. Plug this to the join geometry node. The location is wrong, so we need to duplicate this. Select this transform node, press Shift D, and drop it here. If we change the perspective, we also need to tweak the stroke a little bit. Lower line is the stroke. We can increase the Z scale value to cover more. We can also add the transform node here, and do the same to our loading stroke. If we want, we can add a mesh, set shade smooth node here. It gives a little bit more roundness to the text. Finally, let's change the camera. Press Ctrl+Alt+Numpad 0 to set the frame. Then, select the camera, change the lens type to ortographic. Then you can scale the plane to fit the frame better. Oh yeah, you can totally mix my two tutorials together. By going to File, Append, choose the loading bar blend file, and append the whole collection. In this scene, the camera is pointing upwards, so we need to rotate this RX-90 to match our view. We can also tweak the length to our liking. So let's change the bar build modifier to around 70 and numbers object keyframes to also 70. So yeah, watch the loading bar tutorial next, where I also show you more tips regarding geometry nodes and crease pencil tools. Thanks for watching, and see you next time!